Dear students, today we'll talk about substandards as per the Indian Public Health Standards. We'll have introduction, objectives of the substandard, categorization of substandards, what are the functions of substandard, what is the requirement of manpower substandard, what is the physical infrastructure, equipment, essential drugs, supportive services, waste disposal, record maintenance including vital events, and lastly quality assurance and accountability. In public health sector, substandard is the most peripheral and first point of contact between primary health care system and the community. As on March 2015, we have 153,655 substandards are established in our country. A substandard provided interface with the community at the grassroots level, providing all primary health care services. One lady health visitor and one male health assistant located at primary health center are entrusted with the task of supervision of the substandards. Substandard is a peripheral outpost of the existing health delivery system in rural areas. They are established on the basis of one substandard for every 5,000 population in general and one substandard for every 3,000 population in hilly areas, tribal and backward areas. As we know, one primary health center caters the population of 30,000. Therefore, approximately we have 6 sub-centers will be there for one primary health center. All minimum assured services are essential services as envisaged in sub-center should be available. The overall objective is to provide health care that is quality oriented and sensitive to the needs of the community. Objectives: to specify minimum assured services to is expected to provide and the desirable services to provide through this facility, to maintain acceptable quality of care for these services, to facilitate monitoring and supervision of these facilities, to make services provided more accountable and responsible to people's need. There are two types, categorization of sub-centers, type A and type B. Sub-centers in case of type A are not having adequate space and physical infrastructure for conducting deliveries, due to which providing labor, room facilities and equipment at these sub-centers is not possible. So they are situated in vicinity of the higher health facilities are available. Sub-centers in headquarters areas, that is within the primary health center area. Categorization in case of sub-center B, it provides all recommended services including facilities for conducting deliveries at sub-center itself, expected to conduct around 20 deliveries per month, provided with all labor room facilities and equipment including newborn care corner. They have a good physical infrastructure, preferably they have own building, adequate space, residential accommodation for the health worker and lab room facilities. There are no nearby higher level delivery facilities. In the village health and nutrition day or immunization session, during house visits, during house to house surveys, during meetings and events with the community, all facilities premises it is desirable should provide minimum of 6 hours of routine outpatient department services in a day for 6 days in a week. If 2 ANMs are available at the subcenter, it will remain open for providing OPD services on all working days. Only one of them may provide outreach services at a time. What are the services will be provided at subcenter? Mother and child services, including antenatal, intranatal, postnatal, family planning services, counseling, adolescent health care, school health program, water quality monitoring, promotion of sanitation, field visits, community need assessment, curative services, training for the dais and Anganwadi workers and ASHA workers. Coordination services of Anganwadis, ASHA worker, community health volunteers and sanitation committee. Disease surveillance under IDSP and implement all the national health programs. Recording of all vital events which occurred in her area jurisdiction, and she has to coordinate the health worker and monitor with the Anganwadi worker, ASHA worker, community health volunteers and Panchayat Raj institution. Outreach bar field assistance. Intranatal care, essential promotion of institutional deliveries, skilled attendants at home deliveries when called for, appropriate timely referral high risk cases which are beyond her capacity of management. Essential for type B subcenters, managing labor using pantograph, identification and management of danger signs during labor, proficient in identification and based on first aid treatment for postpartum hemorrhages, eclampsia, sepsis. Minimum 24 hours of stay of mother and baby after delivery at subcenter is essential. Postnatal care. Initiation of early breastfeeding within 1 hour of birth. Ensure postnatal home visits on day, 0 day, 3rd and 7th and 6th week, that is 42 days. And for delivery at home, subcenter, both for mother and baby. In case of low birth weight, that is expected weight of the newborn child is less than 2.5 kgs, additional visits are to be made apart from 0, 3, 7, 42, 14 and 21, 28 days also. During postnatal advice visit, she will advise regarding care of the mother, care of and feeding of the newborn, examination of the newborn for signs of sickness and congenital abnormalities as per IMNC guidelines. Counseling on diet and rest, hygiene, contraception, essential newborn care, immunization, infant, young child feeding. Child health, newborn care in the newborn corner in the labor room to provide essential newborn care, essential if the deliveries are taking place at subcenter B. Assess the growth and development of the infant under 5 children and make timely referral, immunization services, prevention and control of communicable diseases, identification and follow-up referral and reporting of adverse events following immunization. So, family planning and contraception is essential. So, educate the mother, motivate them, counseling to adopt appropriate family planning methods for spacing or for small family norm purpose. So provision of contraception, IUCD, and services to the eligible couple, adopting any family planning method, counseling and appropriate referral for safe abortion services, follow-up for any complications after abortion or MP. Essential curative services, minor ailment including fever, diarrhea, acute respiratory tract infection, and any warm infestation, including first aid to animal bite, wound care, tourniquet, snake bite. Appropriate and prompt referral. Desirable things are: provide treatment as per the Ayush, as per local need. Once a month clinic by the primary health center medical officer or lady health visitor, and A&M should be available for providing assistance. Adolescent health care desirable. Education, counseling, prevention and treatment of anemia, counseling of harmful effects of tobacco cessation. School health services, screening, treatment of the minor ailment, immunization, deworming of the child, prevention management of vitamin A, nutritional deficiency anemia. Referral services through fixed day visits of the school by existing either A&M or multipurpose health worker, male. The staff of the subcenter shall provide assistance to the school health services as a member of a team. Control of locally endemic diseases in her area jurisdiction. All the communicable diseases. IDSP, surveillance about any abnormal increase in the case of diarrhea, dysentery, fever with rigors, early reporting concern primary health center as per the IDSP guidelines, immediate reporting of any cluster or outbreak based on syndromic approach of the surveillance, weekly submission of report to the primary health center in yes form as per the IDSP guidelines. Desirable services: disinfection and drinking water sources like chlorination of water with bleaching powder, and the contents, the availability of the chlorine by through orthologin reagent test by the male worker after chlorination of the well. Outreach for field services should be organized at least at least one in a month. Each village health nutritional day should last for at least 4 hours of contact time between A&M's Anganwadi worker, ASHA worker, and beneficiaries. Essential services at outreach center: early registration, immunization, coordination with ICDS services, family planning services, symptomatic care and management of persons with minor illness referred by the ASHA worker or Anganwadi worker to the sub-center A&M. Health communication to mothers and adolescents. Meet with the ASHAs and provide training support to them as needed. Home visits for skilled attendants at birth, where the woman has opted or had to go in for a home delivery. Postnatal and newborn visits as per protocol. Check out any notifiable diseases. Notify the medical officer, primary center immediately. Desirable visits to home, or visit the house of eligible couple who need contraception, follow-up of cases, visit to community-based DOTS providers, visit to support ASHA for further counseling in family planning services, to take blood slides, smear, and do rapid diagnostic kit tests in case increases with the fever where malaria is suspected. House-to-house survey once in annually, preferable in month of April. One survey per month would be expected. Survey would be done with the support of the participation of the ASHA workers, Anganwadi workers and community health volunteers. Male health worker would take the lead and accountable for organization of the service. What are the essential? House-to-house surveys essentially is age and sex of all family members, assess list of eligible couples and their unmet needs for contraception. Identify persons with skin lesions or other symptoms suspicious of leprosy. Similarly, identify the persons with blindness, identify persons with hearing impairment or deafness, annual mass drug administration in filaria endemic areas, desirable identify persons with a disability, identify the list of senior citizens, identify persons with mental health problems and epilepsy. Community level interactions is essential for focus group discussion for information gathering and health planning. Health communication through village health sanitation nutrition committee meetings with the panchayat members and ASHA worker and self-help groups. Coordination and monitoring of the services with the Anganwadi worker and village health workers. Implement all the national programs, communicable as well as non-communicable diseases. Promotion of medicinal herbs is desirable. Locally available medicinal herbs plants should be grown in and around the sub-centered area. Record of vital events very essential, like births and deaths, particularly of mothers and infants to the health authorities. Manpower requirement is shown in the table form, sub-center A, essential in case of multi-purpose health worker female 1, health worker male 1, desirable 1 more plus 1, second A, what we call. And in a sub-center B, where number of deliveries are more and infrastructure is somewhat good when compared to sub-center A, where essential 2 ANMs must be available. Health worker, one more essential. Staff nurse or ANM desirable in sub-center B. And class 4 employees, maybe part-time worker in sub-center A, but full-time worker in case of sub-center B. Physical infrastructure, it should be located at the center of the village and easy accessible to the people, and as far as possible no person have to travel more than 3 kilometers to reach the sub-center. It should have the boundary walls and fencing with the gate should be provided for safety and security. Residential facility for health worker male needed, and in a typical layout sub-center, residential facility for ANM is included. Provision of ramp with the railing to be made for use of wheelchair or stretcher, trolley wherever feasible. Separate entrance for sub-center and for the ANM quarters may be ensured. Type B sub-center, further they need 4 to 5 rooms with the facility of waiting room, one labor room with a labor table, newborn corner, one room with 2 to 4 beds, one room for storeroom, one room for clinic, office and toilet facilities. Residential accommodation, they need 2 rooms and kitchen and bathroom in case for A&M. residential facility for a minimum 2 staff members and desirable for 3 staff should be provided at type B sub-center. Signage. The building should have a prominent board displaying the name of the sub-center in the local language at the gate and on the building. Prominent display board in language providing information regarding the services available and the timings of sub-center. Visit schedule of A&M should be displayed. Suggestion bar complaint box for patient visitors also to be provided. Information regarding the person responsible for redressal complaints to be displayed. Disaster prevention measures against earthquake, flood and fire. Earthquakes proof measures building structure. AC sub-center should not be located in a low-lying areas to prevent flood. Firefighting equipment, fire extinguisher should be available. The health staff should be trained in that aspect. Environment friendly feature, rainwater harvesting, solar energy use and use of efficient bulbs, waste disposal, biomedical waste. Record maintenance is important and also reporting. Proper maintenance records of services provided at sub-center, both morbidity and mortality data, inertion, births and deaths, sex ratio at birth, which should be monitored and reported. Monitoring mechanism, supportive supervision, record checking at periodic intervals by male and female health supervisors. So quality assurance and accountability is essential through skill development training or continuing medical education of health workers as per NRHM guidelines. So the list of registers to be maintained at sub-center at a glance. Eligible couple register including contraception. Mother and child health service register including antenatal, under 5 register, immunization, growth monitoring, above 5 child immunization, and birth and death register, drug register, equipment furniture for other accessories register, communicable diseases or epidemic register, registries for syndromic surveillance, passive surveillance register for malaria cases, register for records pertaining to Janani Suraksha Yojana, registers maintenance of the accounting including untied funds, register for water quality and sanitation, minor ailments register, records are registers per various national programs including NLEP, RNDCP, etc. As many registered as possible should be integrated. Health management information system format for the sub-center may be strictly followed for collection, recording and reporting. That's the end of the class. Thank you.